E-Center Culinara Schwenningen. Immer gut drauf.
Liebe Zuschauer von NQ-TV, ich begrüße Sie zu einer neuen Folge von Das Eis ist heiß. Im Gespräch sind wir heute mit Will Acton. Welcome. Will, you guys didn't play last weekend, no game. So how was that break for you?
Yeah, it was good. It's nice to kind of get away from the rink a little bit. We play a lot of hockey throughout the season, so to get a little break here before the final push of the season is it's pretty refreshing.
Yeah. What did you do?
Actually, me and my family, we went on a little trip. We went to Salzburg for a couple of days, which was really nice, and we took a couple of day trips, and it's our first time being in Europe, so we wanted to, you know, see some cities and some things, so it was, yeah, it was really nice. Spent some time with the family.
What was your favorite thing about Salzburg?
Oh, it was a beautiful city. Like every city we've been to here, it's been very nice. You know, they had the castle on top of the hill and the scenic views, and everything about it was really nice.
So you guys did practice lately. So what was the main theme in practice so far?
You know, we're working on a lot of things. I think our coaches want to address some areas to our game. So we, you know, we worked on things like that. And the other thing that's important too is just to get skating and to stay in shape and to, you know, keep those repetitions so you can keep the pace of play high. So we got a lot of work in, and we're you know, we have a tough schedule throughout the next couple of weeks. We play a lot of games. And we're just getting ready for the final push here.
So you guys are going to play against Mannheim. They didn't play as well lately. So is that kind of the right time to play them?
Yeah, obviously it's a big derby game. They're, you know, they're our rival team, and it's always exciting to play against them. So yeah, you know, they've had some tough times the last little while. So you know, they've had a little break too. I'm sure they're going to be ready to go, and we're going to have to be on top of our game.
You shed like 50 points in the season, which is amazing. So couldn't it get any better for you?
Well, yeah, I mean, I'd probably trade all the points if we could be in the playoffs as a team. But yeah, I mean, obviously it's a, you know, it's a pretty special feeling to, you know, have that many. And but, you know, I think the importance is kind of on the team winning, and I wish we could have had a couple more wins this year. But, you know, I think some good pieces are in place moving forward.
So what do you think? Who's going to win the playoffs?
Oh, I don't know. Playoffs are a funny thing. I mean, usually it's the hottest team going into the playoffs always has a good chance. And, you know, the top-seeded teams, it's really tight at the top of the standings. And there's a lot of good teams in this league. So it's going to be interesting to watch and to see, who comes away with it. But, you know, we'll see kind of how things go.
You got a well-known father as well, Keith. He almost became the coach in Mannheim, so he did not. So are you, like, sad about it?
No, I don't know. I mean, to be honest, I was kind of late to this. I didn't really know about all these rumors, and I still don't know really how much of it is true. But, yeah, I mean, things like this kind of happen. But, you know, it doesn't really affect me. I kind of come to the rink every day, focus on what I need to do, and, you know, taking part of things here in Schwenningen.
At least he came here in December, and he kind of watched you play. So what did he think about the Wild Wings?
Yeah, he liked it. I think that visit was more of like a, you know, a personal visit. He came to kind of visit me and my family. And I think as a parent, when, you know, a child moves overseas to a new continent, new country, and there's a natural instinct to kind of go and visit and make sure everything's okay. So, you know, as a father, he wanted to come and make sure everything was looked after and that, you know, we were okay as a family. So he enjoyed it. He really liked it. He really liked the atmosphere. He's been involved in hockey in a long time. And here in Europe, it's a little bit different than the way to how it is in North America. So I think he really enjoyed the, you know, the fans and the atmosphere and the style of play and everything. So he enjoyed it.
So what do you think about hockey in the DEL compared to the US, for example?
Yeah, I mean, I like it a lot. I think it's, you know, it's a really high skill game over here. It's fast. Obviously, the ice is a little bit bigger and allows for more times for players to make plays. And the checking is still tight, but you get a little extra time to make a play over here as compared to back home. And there's a lot of skating. And so I like it a lot. I think it's, you know, it suits myself, and I'm enjoying it.
So, and how is the experience living abroad for you?
Yeah, we like it. I mean, obviously, it's different. Me and my wife and our young baby, we're obviously open to new things, and we like, you know, new experiences. And coming over and trying everything and just getting used to the way of life over here has been, you know, very refreshing for us. And we're going to incorporate some of the things we like here back home. And so it's been an amazing experience, and we're looking forward to the years to come.
Nice. So, what's your favorite German dish?
Oh, I probably have to go with the spatula. I've really fallen in love with the spatula dish here. It's probably not the healthiest thing for me, but I indulge every once in a while.
So is it like spätzle with gravy or cheese or whatever? How do you like it?
Yeah, spätzle with the gravy is always really good. I usually get it when we go out to restaurants, so it's usually however the restaurant serves it is usually how I take it. So
you and your family, you guys live in Hochemming. That's a small little village. So how do you like it? Do you still like it?
Yeah, we still like it. I think we've seen everything there's to see there. But Bad Dürrheim's right there in Schwenningen, and we kind of go all over. Usually we go out for lunch and try different spots all the time. So we're on the move, but we certainly like it where we are and go for nice little nature walks all the time and everything. So yeah, we're enjoying it.
Have you found like a favorite loop so far?
A loop, sorry?
A favorite like round where you go for walks?
Yeah, I don't know. We have our own like English names that we kind of gave to them. I'm not familiar with the names, what we call the high path and the low path and all these things. So yeah, it's nice to get out with some fresh air, and we don't really have that too many of those types of things back home. So when we come here, we usually, you know, try to take advantage.
Where will you spend your summer?
In home, me and my wife are from like a little area outside of Toronto, Ontario, small town. So we have a home there, and both of our families are there. So obviously when we're away for 6-7 months of the season here, it's when we get home in the summertime, it's nice to kind of catch up and see family and, you know, for them to see us and our young baby as well. So, you know, we'll take some time there, and which will be nice.
Mm-hmm. You get a 3-year contract here in Schwenning. So you're a real goal getter. Is it somehow difficult for you because it could be that you don't make it to the playoffs in those years? So is it still for you precious to be here?
Yeah, obviously I'm very happy to be here and to stay here. I think I'm looking forward to the years to come. I don't think it's going to be like this forever. I think we got a lot of good pieces in place, and I think we're going to build and move forward. And I think we're going to be, a pretty good team in the future. So, I mean, obviously, you know, focus on the rest of this year, and then, you know, when that's ended, we'll focus on next year. So, kind of take, you know, one things at a time, and, you know, it's a process, and you know, you don't just become a success overnight. You got to put in the work and work on a lot of things. And I think, I think there's some good times to come here. So, I'm happy to be a part of it.
Keith ist ja dead. Will, thank you so much. Ja, liebe NQTV-Zuschauer, das war's für heute mit Will Acton. Er hat kurz gesagt, dass er in Salzburg mit seiner Familie über die freien Tage war, dass sie hart trainiert haben und dass er denkt, dass in den kommenden Jahren, dass die Wild Wings sich steigern können. Deswegen ist er guter Hoffnung. Er fühlt sich nach wie vor sehr wohl in Hochemming, geht auf viele Spaziergänge und im Sommer wird er in Kanada mit seiner Familie sein, wo die Eltern auch in der Nähe sind. Ja, liebe NQTV-Zuschauer, das war's für heute hier mit Will Acton.